So for today's event, your pilot is Manbir, co-pilot is Anshika, and crew member is Rashleen. Over to you, Manbir.
Thank you, Indrani. So now we are going to proceed with our today's presentation. And today, as I told you, we are going to visit Germany. And I hope you all enjoy your tour with us.
Ma'am?
Yes?
I do get confused with Japan and Germany.
Okay. Well, there is a huge difference between Japan and Germany. Okay, I hope my screen is visible to you all.
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Okay, so we are going to visit the airports, zoos, and amusement parks of Germany. So first, we will have a look on all of the airports of the Germany. So in the Germany, there are a total of 36 international airports in Germany, and these ranging from the smaller airfields and only operating for a few routes and the airlines to the mega complexes such as the Frankfurt and Munich that are used for the transport for the 10 million of the passengers per year. So first, we will talk about the Frankfurt International Airport of the Germany. So this is located in the Frankfurt, and it is the fifth largest city of the Germany. And this is one of the world's leading financial centers. So here you can see the logo, the Frankfurt International Airport. And just below that, you can see the aerial picture. So in this picture, you can see the aerial view of the runway and the Frankfurt Airport. Now, proceeding to the next. So the next we have is Munich Airport. So it is located 28.5 kilometers northeast to the Munich, which is near town of Freising, and it is named after the former Bavarian minister, President Franz Josef Strauss, who was born in Munich. So this airport was named on him. So here is another picture, the aerial view of the airport. Please don't annotate on the screen. I can see your names, please don't annotate. Okay, so coming up to the third airport. So this is the Düsseldorf Airport, which is Düsseldorf is the capital of the German state of the North Rhine-Westphalia. So it is about 7 kilometers or 4 miles north to the downtown, and some of the 20 kilometers, which is southwest to the Essen in Rhineland area of the Germany's largest metropolitan. So here you can see another picture of the airport. Now coming up to the next, so it is Berlin Tegel Airport. So this is how their logo looks like. So the airport was named after Otto Lilienthal and was the fourth busiest airport in the Germany, and with having over 24 million passengers in 2019. So in 2016, the Tegel handled over the 60% of all of the airline passengers traffic in the Berlin. So here you can see the infrastructure of the airport. Okay, so now I have a video for you. So this video is of Frankfurt International Airport. See the how huge this place is, right? How huge this airport is. Like it has so many terminals, huge infrastructure. So now we will proceed with our presentation. So after the airport, we will talk about the zoo in Germany. So can you guess the exotic wildlife or the rare species which are found in Germany? Some of the rare species. Like here in picture, you can see some of the common animals like giraffe, rhino, and lion. So anyone can tell me the some of the rare species which are found in Germany?
Ma'am, giraffe.
You can find giraffe anywhere else. I am talking about specifically in Germany. Okay, so for the first zoo which we are going to visit in the Germany is Leipzig. So Leipzig Zoological Garden or the Leipzig Zoo is a zoo in the city of Germany.
Mute everybody. Mute yourself.
Please guest, mute your mics. Okay, so this zoo was first opened in June 9, 1878. It was taken over by the city of Leipzig in 1922 after the World War I, and now it covers about 27 hectares and it contains approximately 850 different species. Now talking to the next, this we have is Nuremberg Zoo. So Nuremberg Zoo is a zoo which is located in the Nuremberg, which is the southwest to the Nuremberg, Germany. So this zoo has an area of 67 hectares, and at this place you can find over 300 different animal species. Coming up to the next, we have Zoo Hanover. So the Hanover Zoo is located in the city of the Hanover, Germany. The zoo was established on 4 May 1865 and this comprises an area of 22 hectares. It contains about 3,414 animals and it has 237 different species which are cared by more than 400 employees in the summer season. Now coming up to the next is Zoo Karlsruhe. So Karlsruhe Zoo is located in the Karlsruhe Central Station in the city of the Karlsruhe, Germany. So this zoo was opened back in 1865 and this is the one of the oldest zoos in the Germany. So this zoo has about 4,400 animals and 250 different species. The next zoo is Schleswig-Holstein-Baden. So this zoo lies in the German Baden Sea. So it was founded by the Parliament of Schleswig-Holstein on 1 October 1985 by the National Park Act of 22 July 1985. And the zoo was expanded significantly in 1999. Okay, so now I have a video for you. I hope my screen is visible to you all.
Flamingos.
Yes.
Ma'am, owl, leopard.
Boy, owl, leopard.
Ma'am, hill, ma'am.
Horse.
Horses.
Ma'am, monkey.
Ma'am, monkey. Ma'am, penguin.
Turtles.
Yes. Zebra.
Ma'am, giant turtle.
Zebra, yes.
And zebra.
Yeah.
Snowing owl.
Ma'am,
lemur.
Seal.
Seal.
Leopard.
Seal.
Sea lions.
Yeah.
Penguin.
Yes. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now we will proceed further. So that was all for the zoo. Now I'll take you to the all of the amusement park of Germany. I hope my screen is visible to you all. Okay, so the first amusement park, and this is the largest theme park, this is Europa Park. So the Europa Park is the largest theme park in Germany and is the second most popular theme park in Europe after Disneyland Paris. So Europa Park is located in Rust, that is southwestern Germany, between Freiburg and Breisgau and Strasbourg. So here you can see a picture of Europa Park. Now moving on to the next, this is Fantasialand. So Fantasialand is a theme park in Brühl. This lies in the North Rhine-Westphalia, Germany. And this place you can see has amazing and attractive roller coasters and rides. So this place has over 2 million visitors annually. So this park was opened back in 1967. And this provides amazing different attractions and rides for the children as well as for the adults. Now, coming up to the next, Hansa Park. So Hansa Park is a seasonal amusement park in Germany, which lies on the off of the Baltic Sea. So it was opened back in May 15, 1977 under the name Hansaland, and it was renamed as Hansa Park in 1987. So it currently spans 113 acres, and this place includes more than 125 attractions. So I found this park really amazing, and that is why I have brought one video, which I'll show you later on Hansa Park. Now moving forward, we have Movie Park Germany. So Movie Park Germany is a theme park in Bottrop, the western of the Germany. So this lies in the 50 kilometer area, and or we can say the 40 hectares. So this is another movie themed park you can enjoy. So now I have a video.
A giant bell.
Yeah, even me too. That seems quite dangerous, but I really would like to have that ride, the giant bell. Okay, anyone else want to say anything? Okay, so that was all for our today's tour to Germany. So for tomorrow, we are going to visit Italy. So I have a little homework for you. So there, like if you have a good interest in drawings or painting, so you can draw any of the animal you can rarely found in Italy. Okay, you can paint or you can draw, you can sketch any of the animal you would like to draw of the Italy.
Yes, please listen.
Okay, so is there anyone who wants to say anything, or we can end this meeting?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so we'll meet you guys tomorrow with the new place, Italy. So I hope you have enjoyed today's tour to Germany. So see you guys. Bye bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.